History runs deep in the veins of West Sussex. Once occupied by the Romans, Anglo-Saxons and Tudors, it's home to some of Britain's best-known castles, stately homes and gardens. In the picturesque market town of Arundel, I met up with local historian Mark Phillips.
So Mark, we can see the castle here behind us, which is obviously the heart of Arundel. Tell me, when was it built and how did the town evolve?
A chap called Roger de Montgomery, who was a friend of William the Conqueror, was given permission to build that castle in, it started in 1067. William the Conqueror said you can build the castle on condition that you have knights in the castle and they're there to go out and quell any rebellions. So he was given about half of Sussex along with the castle. Years went on, the town built up outside the walls and obviously the castle needed trades. So you had the bakers, you had the ironmongers, you had the butchers. So all providing originally supplies to the castle. And it built up, it just gradually grew from that. I would always suggest that the first point of call be Arundel Museum. It's an award-winning museum. It gives you a very good overview of the history of the town. They can advise about walking tours, etc.
The castle is closed during the winter months, but it's actually really advantageous to come when it's not so busy, isn't it?
Oh, definitely. I mean, you've got less traffic, less people. We have beautiful restaurants that are very popular. We have beautiful cafes, eclectic shops. Plus, all the castle grounds, the castle park, all surrounding.
Yeah.
You could have walks around there. It's beautiful all times of year.
20 minutes drive from Arundel, the Weald and Downland Living Museum brings local history to life. Museum director Simon Wardell explains what there is to see.
We're 40 acres of lovely Sussex countryside. We're very proud of our fairly unique collection, 53 historical structures and buildings that have been rescued over the last 50 years from around the area that we represent. There's a time band from Saxon to the Edwardian period represented on the site. We're stood in front of some buildings which were rescued from Crawley High Street.
Oh,
there was
really?
A redevelopment going on there. And just over your shoulder, we've got a market hall from Titchfield.
So this is all about conserving the past, but keeping history alive, really.
That's it. That's spot on. Conservation is at the forefront of what we do here.
And to add to that, you have interpreters, don't you, to help people get into even more detail?
We've got a little over 300 volunteers who will take part in stewarding the buildings or some of the working aspects of the museum. We've got a forge, and a bakery and a mill. It's one of the oldest mills in existence in terms of it still working. We're still making flour, which we sell in the shop. It's quite amazing.
And you also have something of a little hidden star attraction, don't you, as a venue for a particularly well-known TV show?
Yes. Last 4 years, we've been hosting the repair shop, and we have an arrangement with them whereby one of the items from the collection, which is a barn from Leon Solent, and that's where the repair shop is filmed.
No photography allowed, but at least we know it's here.
Absolutely, yeah.
Moving on to Fishbourne Roman Palace and Gardens, just outside Chichester, museum curator Rob Simmons gave me the overview.
We are the largest domestic Roman building north of the Alps, and we are massive, and we're very, very early, built in AD 75. We house some of the earliest mosaics and some of the best mosaics, I think, in Britain.
Tell me about some of the exhibits you have here.
Well, my favourite, just behind you, and that's one of the early ones, one of the black and white floors, AD 75, but the quality of that floor and sophistication of its design is absolutely world class.
And if you're lucky, when the sun comes in, it just gives it this really mystical quality.
It's atmospheric, isn't it? And to think Roman feet trod on that floor 2,000 years ago gives you shivers.
It does, it really does. My favourite is this one over here, which is practically perfect.
That's about 150 AD, 160. But yeah, it's a beautiful thing, it really is.
And in terms of getting here, how easy is it to access?
We've got Fishbourne railway station just up the road. It's a 5-minute walk away, and local buses. The trains are about an hour and a half out of London, so it couldn't be simpler.
And if you wanted to come for a longer stay, say for a weekend, there's plenty of other historic interest in this area, isn't there?
Yeah, well, you've got Chichester itself, which is a beautiful walled Roman city. The Novia Museum. For me, I like to get out onto the Downs and explore, and I absolutely love Kingly Vale, which is a site of more archaeological features than you could possibly imagine.